Hey folks, Rich Heilman here, Dev Advocate, SAP Devs. So check this out, folks. This is pretty cool. We all know how SAP GUI related objects are not supported with ABAP Cloud, things like DIN Pros, list reports, and of course selection screens. But for me, I always love selection screens and how quick and easy you could have a very simple user interface up and running quickly. What if we could bring selection screens to ABAP Cloud? Well, now you can, sort of. OpenMoveDev has posted a blog post announcing the new release of their ABAP2UI5 project. So what is this ABAP2UI5 project all about? Well, the goal of the project is to create an easy and fast way to generate selection screens when using the ABAP Cloud development model. There is minimal effort to create apps using this tool, and the developer is not forced to learn new technologies and languages. Basic ABAP knowledge in general, and of course, knowledge of the selection screen logic, is enough to use this project and create UI5 applications, mimicking the functionality of a standard selection screen. Check out this blog post today for all the details.
If you caught last week's SAP Developer News, you might have seen the segment from DJ on the upcoming SAP CodeJams that we have planned. Well, we're really trying to ramp up the program, and we're now taking submissions for future CodeJams. You can simply head over to the SAP CodeJam community group and post a discussion in the forum if you would like to host a future CodeJam. We just need to know what topic you would like to see as your CodeJam, a little bit about the facility and the location that you'd be hosting, and what kind of date you're looking for. And then we'll work with you to organize the best event that we can. Now, a CodeJam is meant to be a lightweight community event. SAP will send an expert and a community member or multiple members will supply the location and other logistics. We get to have fun doing exercises together. There's group discussion. Our expert will spend the day answering your questions, walking around the room. It's a great way to connect with fellow developers in your area. So if you're interested in that sort of event, then be on the lookout for future CodeJams coming to your area. And if you're really ambitious and ready to support the community, then consider hosting one yourself.
Hola, SAP developers. I recently shared in SAP Community a fun little project that I worked on during the Christmas break. The project involved the SAP Community RSS feed, an ink display, a Raspberry Pi, some Python code, and even a 3D printer. I include a link to it in the description below in case you're interested in building one yourself. I encourage you to share those cool projects that you work on in SAP Community. I am looking forward to reading about them soon.
We've covered these two topics in recent SAP Developer News episodes, but wanted to remind you of them also this week. First, there's the 2023 SAP Developer Insights Survey, which is still open for the next few weeks. If you haven't done so, we'd like to encourage you to fill it out. I did it this morning and it took me 5 minutes. I timed it. The survey is open until the beginning of March, so you still have some time, but why not grab a coffee in your next break and follow the link in the description and go and fill it out. Happy surveying. Also, in last week's episode, we talked about the SAP CodeJams in 2023. We wanted to remind you that the SAP CodeJam discussion group over on SAP Community's website is the place not only to discuss all aspects of the program, but also to request a CodeJam in your area. There's not much you need to provide to host an SAP CodeJam. Power, a good internet connection, enough space for folks to sit and work and get to know each other, and hopefully also some lunch. Pizza is always a winner. So get in touch if you want to request one, and maybe see you in 2023.
Hi, everyone. The SAP Fiori Development Newsletter issue number 20 for January 2023 is out. It contains a nice collection of links and articles that will help you get up to speed with everything new in the SAP Fiori world. It summarizes the key takeaways from SAP Ticket 2022, what's new for CAP, RAP, custom theming, and mobile apps, and also how to implement SAP Fiori in SAP S/4HANA. Check it out and also consider subscribing.
You might remember an interview on artificial intelligence ethics my teammate Nora did with Sebastian Wieczorek as part of our Developers Digest show. Now, Sebastian and the AI team at SAP would like to invite you to the full AI Ethics at SAP Open Online course. In this course, you'll learn the importance and principles of AI ethics, how AI ethics is implemented at our company, and which rules employees need to follow during the development, deployment, use, and sale of AI systems. And then in the second half of February, another openSAP course starts called Building AI and Sustainability Solutions on SAP BTP. Our colleagues from the partner ecosystem team will help you to learn how to transform a business into an intelligent, sustainable enterprise using solutions on the SAP Business Technology Platform and to discover how artificial intelligence plays a critical role in this journey. To get a better understanding of the processes, instructors will walk you through the end-to-end scenario, complete with hands-on exercises and sample code.